New York is the state that has the most number of cases.
Yeah. Check it.
Other states are doing it because the more tests they're doing, the more cases they will find.
Unlimited epidemics being spreaded.
So we're going to put out an executive order today. New York State on pause.
Another five elements to search for the higher intelligence. Women walk around celibate, living irrelevant. The most benevolent king.
Hi, my name is Juan Alvarez. I'm Dominican. I help my family run two bodegas. Very Latino, typical school, you know, but it's been an experience being there for my family and learning what it is to be a hardworking person. I think that's one of the best things that I'm so grateful. Hey, what is Juan doing? Juan's working.
Dominicans, we love music. The older I get, the more I realize I do want to explore that aspect of myself. I've been drawn to the piano and just that kind of music that's just soft. I like music that really brings you into awareness or just brings you to the present. You know, I know usually when people think about like pop, rock, all this other music, but I just like music that lets you sit down, chill. Like, think about like soft music. You're going down the beach, summertime, windows are down, breeze hitting you, just nice chill music, you know? This whole quarantine situation, I am not, like, I haven't been tired doing my shift. I'm active, you know, I'm moving around, like, I'm not tired, I'm good. I think it's been a blessing, or maybe just been like flight or fight mode, you know? I feel blessed, I feel grateful. There's so many people who don't have any work right now. Today, as of today, it's 26 million people who applied for unemployment. Besides the fact that, yeah, I'm out there, I'm risking getting sick, etc., I'm still grateful for what I have, you know? But now I just find the middle ground. Now I find the balance of like, okay, so today I'm gonna do self-care, I'm gonna do some of this, some of that, and take care of myself so that I'm ready for tomorrow. Doing the job that we've taken away from the Americans.
There's no going back there. You would be stupid to do so. You have to come out of this evolved and more aware of everything and how everything's interconnected. How the treatment of the planet, how we treat each other, new ideas, bright ideas, beautiful things, you know? Which is hard to execute because, you know, inequality.
When you're somebody who's conscious about inequality, naturally, you're always thinking about these things. But I think the pandemic has really, really highlighted that. Inequality, racism, lack of proper health and hygiene. Like, you'll be surprised how many people don't know proper hygiene, you know? Like, why are you touching your face with the gloves you just used? You know, like,
cross-contamination. Yeah, this pandemic has been stressful. It's been stressful. Just keeping it 100%, it's been stressful. But it also teaches you a lot.
I like that, the humanity. It's one of my things. with the corona situation happening, we've been having to come into contact with our humanity. It makes you think and reflect about the things that you run away from every day. We're always running away from our problems, our issues with ourselves, our trauma, the hurt inner child, and coming into contact with that inner child and this, and asking like, what didn't you have that you need now, you know? In terms of myself, I think the last 5 years, I think I've been exploring the inner child. Why am I the way that I am? And how am I perceived and how do I treat the other people around me, you know? Realizing how much I missed having a strong bond with parents, you know, because I'm still grateful for the love that I receive and being nourished and all the things parents do for kids. Affection and physical embrace when I was a kid, didn't get a lot of that, you know. Where we are all grappling with being present. And being present, it's so important right now. Empathy, compassion, and understanding that we're all going through this shit together. For the more reason to treat other people with a sense of decency and respect.